Welcome to our presentation on
the chemistry of muscle fatigue. Let's get to it. So what is muscle fatigue? First of all, the definition is the decline in ability of a muscle to generate force. Therefore, so the muscle is going to be, it's going to be getting tired, it's going to be strained a lot, and so this can be a result of vigorous exercise, but there's also a chance of abnormal fatigue. Can be caused by barriers to or interference with the different stages of muscle contraction. So this is usually from strenuous activity, and it's basically a byproduct of exercise.
So now we're going to move into why muscles fatigue. Muscles fatigue due to the buildup of lactic acid within muscles. That's what happens when muscles are stressed or you do a strenuous exercise. Contrary to popular opinion, lactic acid is actually not the thing that brings about the feeling of soreness after an exercise. It's the burning feeling you have in active muscles.
So what about the pH in the muscles? The basic human body and the muscles, it usually starts at 7. Their pH level is 7. That's what the equilibrium is and the normality. But when you're fatigued, the pH drops to about 6.4 or 6.6. And this is because the muscles are wearing out because the H+ ion, that concentration increases, because it's becoming more acidic with the introduction of lactic acid.
So now we're going to talk about ADP, or as I like to call it, adenosine diphosphate. It's essential to the functioning of muscles, and what ADP does is it creates contractions, and after you use up all of the ADP available in your body, that's when you start to create lactic acid, and then therefore creating oxygen.
So the heat and temperature in the muscles. So during extreme temperatures, usually when it's far hotter, muscles tend to be weaker and slower, and so the fatigue is going to occur much, much faster. So as the muscles contract during the exercise, the muscles actually create some of the heat. So it doesn't just have to be hot for you to fatigue, but it certainly helps in the process. The heat actually flows away from the muscles, and then so it's heating the surrounding bits, which is the fluids and the blood. The body tries to regulate this, but sometimes heat exhaustion can be a problem.
So now we're going to move into treatment of muscles both before and after exercise, or therefore fatigue. Before you exercise, it's important to stretch. This loosens your muscles and relieves the stress that's been building up while you've been sitting around not doing anything. Then you have your workout. After your workout, it's very important to rest. While you're resting, extra blood is sent to your muscles, and this way the tiny tears in your muscles, which is what actually strengthens your muscles, can have time to heal, which is very important. And if you don't rest or you push your muscle beyond its capacity, it can tear too much, which is when you have a pull or a strain, or obviously you can tear completely.
So related to athletics. What a lot of researchers and scientists are trying to do is they're trying to delay the fatigue so that professional athletes and anyone who wants to maybe work out for longer, they can, it aids in their performance. So what Troy and I are going to go over, we're going to go over three athletes in PK Subban, Tom Brady, and Mookie Betts.
So we're going to talk about PK Subban first. NHL players like PK Subban deal with a grueling 82-game regular season, along with the possibility of several months of playoffs. It's a very violent sport, as anyone who's watched it knows, and endurance is key. To keep their muscles in good condition, NHLers keep healthy diets, recover quickly, and they build up a solid mass in the offseason.
So you can do things like this. That's what the goal is, basically.
If you rest properly, you can do that too.
Yes. So our next athlete, we've got Tom Brady. So what Tom Brady, he chalks up his extended experience and career in the NFL, being 40 years old in his 18th year, he chalks it up to keeping his body healthy and specifically his muscles. So Tom has his personal trainer, Alex Guerrero. He stayed for him for a long time. And they're some main advocates for something called muscle pliability, which is basically keeping your muscles pliable, so that means they're strong, they're active, and mostly they're easily flexible. So this is kind of what Brady calls his prehab, so that he can prevent injuries before they actually happen.
So now we're going to talk about Mookie Betts, one of baseball's best young players. A lot of people give the MLB some hate for having some athletes who are not in the greatest shape, but there's no doubt that the MLB season is 162 games, which is still very long. Mookie Betts is very fit. He relies on lifting weights and running for a good workout. He has a very consistent effort. His recovery is very simple. He rests and keeps hydrated.
So basically what our experiment is going to entail that you'll see in a second is an intense lacrosse workout. What we're going to be doing is shooting in the hot sun. We're going to be shooting for a while, about 45 minutes. Involves a lot of muscles in that shooting. Then we're going to go to the gym, and we've got some weight training done and then some sprints. And the chemistry behind that is that the lactic acids will build up in our muscles and our body after the ADP has been used up. Our pH levels are going to decrease, and there's going to be some acute muscle tears for the training.
Welcome to our experiment. We're going to be shooting 1,000 lacrosse balls. Our muscles are going to get pretty fatigued.
Once we're done, we'll come check back in on you and see how our muscles are doing.
Thanks for watching our video, and that was The Chemistry of Muscle Fatigue. Those are our sources.